My name's Eric Wielander, and welcome back to my channel all about apps and gear in the Apple ecosystem. Today is our first ever 2-Minute Tuesday. So today I'm gonna show you how to take those beautiful screensavers from the Apple TV and use them as your screensaver on your Mac. Okay, so first all you need to do is go to github.com/johncoates/Arial. Now don't worry, I know this GitHub has source code. This is not gonna involve a lot of crazy geeky stuff. It's really easy. So you just go over here to this big green button here, clone or download, and download zip. If you're the kind of person who does like geeky stuff, I highly recommend trying to install it with Brewcask. If you know what Brewcask is, it's great that it supports it. But for the easy demo today, we're just gonna download the zip of the screensaver. And then from there, we're just gonna go ahead and unzip that. So now we have a folder. From there, there's this Arial.saver file. So we're gonna click on this file and I'm just gonna drag it out to the desktop for now. But you can do whatever you wanna do to move files. We're gonna go in the Finder menu up here to go to folder, and then do /library. It's already in my setup. And then if you double click if you scroll down to the bottom of this list and double click on screensavers, then from there, you probably will see an empty folder. Just click and drag Arial.saver into there, or copy paste, whatever works for you. And then that's it. In system preferences now, you'll have an option in screensavers for Arial. So you just go select that and you can choose screensaver options. And then you can choose which of the different options there are that you want it to play. So now if we go down to the corner for that hot corner, it's gonna trigger the screensaver. One of the things to note here, one issue about this though, is that it's currently only in 1080p. There's quite a long running issue about 4K support, and it looks like it's really tough to get the 4K files that are meant for the 4K Apple TV to work on all the different potential 4K setups that you might have on a Mac. So a question for you guys down in the comments, do you ever think Apple will make this a standard feature in macOS? Thanks again so much for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up down below if you liked it. Subscribe to this channel if you aren't already, and I'll see you in the next one.